Well, the finance ministers of the euro area are coming in their capacity as governors of the ESM, so that's the top political body. They have to do that once a year to approve the annual report, the annual accounts. And of course, it's a good opportunity to review the work of the ESM. 2013 was the first full year of operation for the ESM, because we were created in October 2012, and also an opportunity to look into the future. We are almost there. We have a staff count of 130 right now. We will continue to grow a little bit, but not too much. All the teams are working, the funding team, the lending team, the investment team investing 80 billion of paid-in capital. We have economics teams in each of our borrowing countries. The risk management is working, liquidity management, communication, all the different teams are up and running. Five countries have borrowed from the EFSF and the ESM. These countries are Ireland, Portugal, Greece, Spain, and Cyprus. Three of the five have exited their program already, so which is a big success. It shows that the approach is working, the crisis response is working. Two countries, Greece and Cyprus, are still under their programs and still have some money to draw from the EFSF or ESM. For the five countries, we have disbursed from the EFSF and the ESM around 230 billion euro. Well, we are a permanent crisis institution, so we will continue to exist. We have to be there because we know this crisis will come to an end, but we also know there will be another crisis one day. We don't know when, but we have to be prepared for that. But then we will have a lot of work to do anyway to manage our balance sheet, because we disbursed 230 billion so far, which will even increase a little bit more. That needs to be managed, because some of the loans have maturities of up to 32 years. That also means we have to roll over our exposures again and again, because on our liability side, we have an average maturity of only 6 years. So EFSF and ESM will be in the market every year and issue around 30 to 40 billion euro, even with the crisis being over. In addition, we have to invest our paid-in capital of 80 billion euro, which is a big sum of money, and we have to do it very carefully and conservatively. We also have special relations with the countries that borrowed from us. Like any debtor has special relations with a creditor. So we will be in permanent touch with the five countries that borrowed from us to monitor their budgetary and economic developments, their liquidity management, to make sure that we can be repaid. And this will last as long as the loans last. So in some cases, this will be more than 30 years. In the banking sector, we have a special role. There's political agreement on direct bank recapitalization. We are finalizing this new instrument. We still need, in the end, the unanimous decision by our governors to create this instrument, but we are preparing ourselves internally. In addition, we have the instrument available for lending to governments to restructure banking systems, as we did in the case of Spain. So these are the two instruments available inside the banking union.
We want to do more. It's possible.
That's right,
which could seem a bit odd.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
I hope I haven't reached that age yet.
Hello.